Hey, we're in Sweet Home, Oregon. We're at the Oregon Trail Banjo Camp, Ralph Martin's place. I live next door. Ralph is my father. We get together every year and have a big party. We invite banjo players from all over the country and other parts of the world. We just have a big party. Eat, drink, and play a lot of music. Well, the party typically is July 1st through the 4th. But sometimes people show up 2 or 3 weeks early and stay 2 or 3 weeks late. So it varies each year. Some of the friendships go back 40, 50 years to a group of people that have been involved with the banjo, and once they're in there, they stay for life. So it's a lot of good people here.
I live in Stevensville, Montana.
How long have you been playing the banjo?
Let me think. 74 years, off and on. Mostly on, but 74 years. I started at 5 years of age, so I'm 79, so my calculation says 74.
And you know better than you are?
That's right. I've never really progressed. I've been in a standstill.
Tell me what the banjo camp is.
Just a bunch of people that love the music and love each other, and they get together and they play and have fun and drink a few drinks and eat a lot of good food and meet their old friends and meet some new ones. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, I tell you, it's really beautiful to listen to the quality of strumming.
Yeah.
It seemed like everybody got a little bit just really clean and clear in this. So I was hearing the big banjo sound, which I've never heard before.
Uh-huh.
So can you describe that, sort of what it's like to play in a room full of big banjo sound?
hard on your ears for one thing. but it's something you can do if you decide you have to do it. You hear your banjo and you know the song they're playing, so you just kind of go along with the thing just like you would anything else, like walking out here on the sidewalk or anything. It's something you do naturally. The way I do it, anyway. Works for me.
Well, you're missing your dinner place. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Just introduce your full name. Just a second.
Montana Red is what my name is, Dick Lewis, but I go by the handle of Montana Red in the banjo playing world. And I play for weddings, funerals, bars, or any place that wants banjo music that's willing to throw a few coins in the kitty.
So tell me why I don't see more young people here learning banjo. Why isn't the banjo, is the banjo an instrument that people are taking up now? Or?
They're afraid of it. It's more difficult to play than a lot of instruments, for one thing. There's no teachers, not enough teachers, and music has changed over the so many decades and years and generation and everything. It's a generational thing, and the music they play now isn't associated with a banjo. And so that's about the sum total of it. But it's a funny thing. You can get around even young people and play, and old people in middle age. And once they hear the sound, they sort of get kind of drawn to it, kind of get hooked on it. Because it's a unique sound, you know what I mean? If it's played right, you know?
It's time tomorrow, reckon there I'll be. Hanging from a white oak tree. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die.
I have no intention of quitting because this is all I know of music. You know, I've played them all my life mostly. So I'm going to stick with it. I'm not changing. I'm not going to change horses in the middle of the stream.
Most of the music that banjo players, the four-string banjo players play, have always been considered the old standards, which are the 20s and 30s, and, you know, some earlier, some later. But we can play practically anything. It's just those kind of fit the era for the banjo popularity. There's a lot of novelty tunes, but most of them are back in the 20s and 30s, 40s and 50s. But it's basically the 20s is when the banjo really became popular.
Thank you.
My name is Juan Olive, and I'm here in connection with Banjo Camp. The Martins are our friends, and I have my wife here, Donna, and we are a participant in the preparation of logistics and dinners, stuff like that. And we are very enthusiastic about the outcome of this Banjo Camp. We see friends from far Florida and all point east of the Mississippi as well as west of the Mississippi. And our local people here enjoy this kind of music interlude and fellowship. So we are very pleased to be here as a participant.
Some reason, and those are real bees. They're not stinging me at all. They do not listen to jets.
Here we are
I'm eating whatever they give me, and it's very good. It looks very good. I had a wonderful day. Every day is wonderful around here. I've been here a week and every day gets better.
I don't know what I have. Food.
You again?
I would.
Yeah, bad penny always returns, you know.
Shout out to the old biddy. Fix you right up. Water? Oh, had an excellent day. Excellent show. Another good time was had by all. Other than the lights going out,
it was pitch black in the women's bathroom.
There you go.
I'll tell you, it's a good video gig when the bartender knows what to drink without asking.
Hey, I remember from year to year what everybody drinks.
Cheers.
I do, seriously. Salud.
Hey, my name is Larry Caputo, and I'm up here from the San Jose area. I play banjo in the Peninsula Banjo Band, and this is my fourth year up here, and I have such a great time that I'll probably come up here every year that they have this function.
I've been a singer all my life, honey. I come from Michigan originally, and I've been in California since 1961. And I sang with Ralph Martin's band starting in the mid-80s until I moved up north to the mountains in 1990. Well, Ralph Martin is the master of the banjo, and it was his idea. He started having these kind of collector, you know, meetings way back in, in the early 80s. I wasn't able to go to his first one, but after that, I went to every one. I don't think I've missed any of his. And it's just to bring people together that love playing the banjo, love music, and that's what we do. Make people happy.
St. Louis woman with a diamond ring. Lead that man around by her apron string. Purple powder and a gold on hand. The man I love has got a heart like a rock has in the sea.
Most of them are held in hotels and places like that. Ralph's not the only place where it happens at his house, and it's so informal. And on the meals and stuff. Well, you see what goes on here. That's what happens every year up here. We've been doing it up here since
soul. They all went away and stood singing, oh, bye, 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 bye. Oh, bye, gee, the only girl for me, Mr. Andy Hall.
Band down in Oakland called the Oakland Banjo Band. And at one time, we really had the privilege of having Dick Martin come in and sit in the front row and show us how it was supposed to be done. And one of the very first songs that I learned from Dick's expertise was a number called I Love a Banjo. It was written by a banjo player. And we'll ask Dick to intro this and the rest of the band join in. fellow musicians here. He's a banjo player. He's masquerading as a tuba player today. His name is Tom Dutart. And besides, I'm sure there's other birthdays in the group. We're not ignoring you, we're just not including you. This is Bob, what's your name? Tom Dutart. Tom Dutart is infamous and famous in the world. He is, I believe, president of the Monterey Jazz.
I'd like to make an announcement. There's a car in the parking lot. I'd like to take this opportunity. I want to do this for Tom. Now, Tom is just a marvelous guy. His birthday's today. And you probably noticed that everybody that does something needs some glue to kind of hold it together. So these guys over here in the rhythm section is holding us together, okay? So this might fall apart because this group has never done this tune with me before. So I'm going to have to try not to ignore you, but direct them. When Tom was young, he had a lot of pep. He could get around, he didn't need any help. I couldn't have written it any better. Now he's old and he's getting gray. The folks all look at him and say he's too old. Too darn old, he's too old to cut the mustard anymore. He's getting too old. Too darn old, he's too old to cut the mustard. Catch on quick.
Tom used to jump just like a deer.
Now he needs a new lamb.
He used to jump a picket fence.
Now he's lucky if it jumps an inch or two.
Thank you. Thank you.
Earlier that we include this next song in it because they loved it so much, and it's called I Can't Give You Anything But Love, Baby. You can pronounce that differently if you want to. But. Thank you.
It was just pointed out to me that we have an international person in our group today. The washboardist in the back there. Lives, I guess, about 9 months out of the year. Play 2 G's and 1 C. Take it from Dick. Thank you. very much, and expect Ron Franklin and his group to be back here next 4th of July.
I thought it was wonderful. Each year it's better.
Well, this is the 18th year, and they've had a lot of people here, but this is one of the best.
Have you been here before?
Yes. Always a wonderful performance. We're never disappointed. Love to sing along too. Great stuff.
It's been July, 4th July.
Yeah, great.
Our pleasure.
Oh, everyone hungry.
Oh. Oh, we love it, yes, we've been coming every year since they started.
We're here once again celebrating the 4th of July with Ralph and all his friends at the VFW here in Sweet Home, like we do every year, bringing our banjo friends from all over the country over to put on a little show. Thank you very much for having us. See you next year.